Hello everybody and welcome. My name is Brady Erickson. I'm with the technical support team here at Amtrol, and today we're going to have a tech take on how to descale your hot water maker heat exchanger. So there's two ways to do it. The first way is a little bit more complicated, but it would involve removing the heat exchanger from your unit, external, and then power washing it, which can get all the scale and any buildup off that coil, and then reinstalling it within the tank. The second method would allow everything to stay together would be to introduce a solution into the volume that's already within the tank and allowing that chemical reaction to take that scale off, and then you could flush it out the bottom. So the process to do that is going to be a few steps. The first step is going to be to turn off the cold water supply going to the hot water maker. Once the cold water supply is shut off, we want to go to the nearest faucet anywhere in the house where you have a hot water tap, open up that hot water tap until all the water is released, all the pressure's out until it runs empty, and then leave that hot water tap open, because that will come into play later. Next, you're going to come down to the unit and you're going to locate the relief valve. So you're going to want to take a 5-gallon bucket and you want to go underneath the dip tube from that relief valve and open it up. That's going to allow any residual volume, any residual pressure from the tank to be removed. And then you can actually remove the relief valve itself. You want to take this piece off of your tank. Once the relief valve is removed, now we're going to take some volume out of the tank, so some of that water. How much water you want to take out will depend on the size of your water heater. So take a look at the chart on the screen, see which one applies to you. So it's going to be anywhere from 3 buckets up to 4 or 5 buckets. And we want to remove that water, which is going to take that water level down low enough where we can allow some solution to come in. So the solution I'm referring to is actually going to be distilled white vinegar. It's the least corrosive of some of the solutions that are available out in the market, but we do want to make sure we're protecting the other parts of the tank as well as getting the scale off our coil. So with that distilled white vinegar, we're going to, again, it's going to depend on how much you're using per the volume of your tank. So again, take a look at that chart there, see which one applies to you, and that's how much vinegar we would recommend for that unit. That white vinegar is going to be poured into that relief valve that we just removed. So I'd recommend using a funnel, and you want to pour that vinegar into your hot water maker. Once that vinegar has been poured in, we want to allow the unit to heat for 2 to 3 hours. The longer it heats, the better. It's going to allow that heat exchanger to get really warm, and it's going to allow that chemical reaction to occur. After that 2 to 3 hours, we want to go ahead and turn off the hot water heater, and then we're going to drain down all the water that's in there. So that solution, it should have a lot of minerals on it, hopefully, because that's all the scale from the coil. So we want to use, again, that garden hose on the bottom, drain out any solution that's within the tank, and then this is where we'd also recommend to run a few flushing cycles through it. So you want to slowly let some of that cold water in, allow it to move within the tank, and then flush it out, again, 2 to 3 times to get until it's running clear and we get all of those minerals out. After that's complete, we can go ahead, close up our drain valve, we can reinstall our relief valve, and then we're going to open up that cold water supply slowly. Again, this is where it's important that we make sure we leave the hot water tap open, so any air that's stuck within the system will be flushed out until we get a nice steady stream of water, because that unit's all the way filled up, and then we can shut off that hot water tap. Lastly, we want to turn our unit back on, allow it to heat up to temperature, and we'll be good to go. If you have any questions or any concerns, or you have something specific to your application we didn't cover today, please give us a call or reach out to us on our website at amtrol.com. We'd be happy to assist you. Thank you very much for watching today's Tech Take, and we'll see you next time.